Right. I think that kid is battling the gym. In Pokemon Go. Right. The vine is going to have to be down for this one because it's pissing it down. We had a few days of beautiful weather, but obviously that was surreal because it's England, so back to shitty rain. I'm going to start, like, when I actually ride somewhere, I'm going to start filming instead of, like, going out just to film. I didn't even see that car, I was too busy focused on talking. Shit. So, like, instead of, like, going out and designating time to film, I'm just going to film whenever I ride somewhere. So hopefully that should be in my videos, because I ride a lot, to be honest. One thing I wouldn't recommend when riding a scooter is wearing ripped jeans when it's raining, because yours truly has done so. And it's not raining, it's spitting, but it's having moments where it throws it down. So it gets a bit chilly on the old knees, you know? I can already feel it. Well, I can't have it up because my face gets soaking wet. Unless I like do that. I can feel it though. I can feel the wind noise on my chin, and when I can feel it on my chin, that's when the noise can be like bad in the microphone. So it's just like, I do. So I want to dedicate this video to a topic that one of you brought up in the comment section, and that is, how much did it cost to run a scooter? And that can range from like petrol, any maintenance that you might need to do on it, tax and insurance. Now, I'm not going to tell you my specifics, like how much mine costs accurately, because I don't think it's something like I should share, but I'm going to give you an estimate. Like, you all know my scooter by now, so you should like get an idea. This hill is such a pain in the ass to go up, and I have a really itchy head. That's one of the worst things, like not being able to scratch your head. When you've got an itchy head, it's like awful. Oh, for God's sake, I hate it so now because I can't start up again. This is going to be a key embarrassing moment on this channel.
Come on, use your feet, son, come on. Use your feet. I'm literally going this way because I can't help it. Alright, come on.
There we go, I need to get to this bit and then I'm good. Well, I'm alright. Come on. There we go. Fuck's sake. Right, okay. So. Can I feel the wind noise? Maybe if I like look down. I can still feel wind on my chin. And it's where my microphone is, so. Maybe something's gonna have to change with like placement and stuff, I don't know. But. How much does it cost to run a scooter? And trust me, it's a lot cheaper than a car. Go on, I'll move in for you. I don't like people overtaking me here, but then again, I don't mind because I go ridiculously slow. If they want to risk it, they can risk it, but there we go. To be honest, it makes me feel more comfortable as well. I know I was kind of like contradicting myself because I had a rant on it the other day, but it makes me feel more comfortable knowing there's no one waiting behind me. Sorry, I keep getting sidetracked. It's a lot cheaper than a car. When you're 17 and you get a car, your insurance is sky high. Especially when you're a male, because people think you're just going to be like a boy racer and ragging your car around everywhere. Might not even be the case, but that's what insurance companies think. So for a first driver in a car, your insurance as a boy is going to be sky high. I'm sorry, you can't hear me. I don't know whether I should speak yet or not, because I don't know if you can hear me. Oh well. Right. So as I was saying, as a teenage male, your insurance is going to be sky high. Because the insurance company thinks it's going to be like a boy racer and stuff like that. But even though it might not be the case, that's what they're going to think. So your insurance will be like £1,200 to £1,600 a year, which is an insane amount. Now I have a year's no claims, so I don't know if that's going to give me any discount or anything, but... The rain's starting to come down a bit now. I'm so happy that was green. I don't want to wait in this rain, oh my god. Oh! Right. So my insurance for this MBK or Veto, for everyone that keeps asking, it's like a Yamaha Neos. Fuck my knee, that's soaked. Like a Yamaha Neos. Practically the same as a Yamaha Neos, just a different make, so it's like a copy. Oh my god, it does me well. It runs well. It's only failed on me once. So it's good. And my insurance on this is like somewhere around £180 a year. And my tax is £17 a year. My knees are fucking soaked. So as you can tell, that's pretty cheap. I mean, if you go and compare the market and check out insurance is like a little Nissan Micra car for your age, it's still going to be expensive. No matter how shit the car is, it's still going to be expensive. But scooter insurance is cheap. And that's why I'd recommend getting a scooter over a car first, until you can get like a sustainable job, to get a sustainable income, which you can rely on, which you can then use to pay for your insurance. The only downfall of scooters is this. I mean, you can see how wet I'm getting. You can see how unpleasant it is. I should not have worn ripped jeans. I don't get why I didn't change them, because I saw it was raining. And I just got sprayed back to the front by that white lorry. I can literally see the rain bouncing off the road. Wow. What fun. The rain is now seeping through my jacket, onto my clothes. I am soaked. I am freezing, this is not fun. But what can you do but laugh about it, I guess. There's nothing you can do. Once you've committed to the journey, you've got to just keep on going. I'm not going to say that again because that was kind of cringy, but it's true. You can't do anything but laugh about it. Like the other day, I was riding home and it literally started like full on hailing. And full on thundering. And literally I got soaked through. I got that soaked, underneath my skin got wet. It soaked through all my clothes, and then it soaked through my skin. Obviously it didn't, it's just an exaggeration, but honestly, I got drenched. And what worse than this? And then I came to every single red light I possibly could do. And then I just started laughing to myself. I was just riding, laughing to myself. Now I look back on it, I probably looked well weird, but... There's not more you can do, but power on through. And even brought a spare change of clothes either. I'm actually riding to my girlfriend's house, so I'm just going to be sat there, drenched. Oh, sorry, I forgot to mention. A full tank for me, a full tank in my mum's car is about £70, and a full tank for me. Is £6. So just bear this sort of stuff in mind when considering getting a car or a bike. It's just something to think on.